If he's installing an ERV, energy recovery ventilator, is it not easier just to have an HVAC system for cooling and ventilation? That's a comment that I got on my last video on residential geothermal. We'll cover ERVs, HRVs, and compare them with regular HVAC systems. Proper airflow is vital for ensuring a healthy and comfortable indoor atmosphere. Energy recovery ventilators, ERVs, and heat recovery ventilators, HRVs, exchange stale indoor air with fresh outdoor air while minimizing the energy loss to do so. This means you can get all the benefits of fresh air without sacrificing heating or cooling efficiency in your home. In a nutshell, ERVs and HRVs both swap air and recover energy. The only difference is that ERVs can also handle humidity. ERVs and HRVs both use heat exchangers to save energy by maintaining the indoor temperature. ERVs and HRVs typically save between 50 to 80% of the energy that would otherwise be lost through ventilation. Some companies advertise 95 plus energy savings, but 50 to 80% already sounds pretty good to me. So ERVs can also keep the moisture inside or outside the home, whereas HRVs, you pretty much get the same humidity as outside or inside the home, which can lead to moisture and mold. This is useful for extreme climates, where you typically wish for a significantly different humidity inside compared to outside. The lower absolute humidity of cold air during the winter time would make the air pretty dry inside the home with an HRV in cold weather, whereas the ERV can maintain the level of humidity that the indoor temperature can hold. Likewise, in tropical areas, the humidity would be too high outside for the indoor temperature with an HRV, possibly leading to condensation or even mold. Now, is a dehumidifier required in humid areas in addition to an ERV? Based on my research, an ERV can help maintain humidity to a large extent. To effectively control the moisture inside the home in extreme humid areas, a dehumidifier might be beneficial. To be more precise, an ERV helps to improve indoor air quality by exchanging stale indoor air with outdoor air while also recovering energy. ERVs are very useful in humid climates because they can help manage humidity levels by transferring some of the moisture from the incoming air to the outgoing air during the exchange process. According to the Home Ventilation Institute, ERVs are typically recommended for warmer, humid climates with longer cooling seasons. A dehumidifier, on the other hand, is specifically designed to reduce the humidity levels in a space by extracting moisture from the air. In very humid areas where the humidity levels remain high, even with ventilation, a dehumidifier may be necessary to maintain a comfortable and healthy indoor environment. Dehumidifiers work independently of ventilation systems and can be particularly useful in basements, bathrooms, or other areas that are prone to excess moisture. Radiant cooling is quiet, dust-free, efficient, and has been used in Europe for decades. Studies by the Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory in California estimate the energy savings of radiant floor cooling to be over 30% of traditional forced air cooling systems. Now, how does the dust-free aspect play out if you need an ERV for ventilation and humidity regulation? Well, first of all, ERVs need much less ducts than traditional HVAC systems. However, like any air treatment system, including forced air HVAC, ERVs are not maintenance-free. What is supposed to be the healthiest air treatment system cannot do its job properly if it's not maintained, meaning the filters are exchanged about every 6 months if you live close to traffic, or a bit less on the countryside. So now you could say, for an ERV, I have to install ductwork anyway. Shouldn't I just use it to cool? So essentially install regular HVAC with radiant heat? The short answer is no. It takes up more room, costs more, and looks worse. ERVs need much less ductwork compared to regular HVAC systems. The ductwork an ERV needs can be tucked away above a laundry room or a storage room. It looks like 2 out of 3 Americans remove their shoes before they enter a home. However, I assume a large fraction of those were flip-flops or some sort of house shoes or at least socks at home, let alone using carpets. So does cooling your home with in-floor radiant cooling really affect the comfort in your home, even if you go barefoot, especially if there isn't that much temperature regulation required, if you have really good insulation? Unfortunately, I couldn't find that much statistics on that. However, I would expect the percentage of people who even notice the difference to be very low. Instead, I'd expect an increase in comfort level at home because you're taking away the air draft and temperature imbalances in your home. In the residential geothermal video, Dennis said this.
At first you'll say, well, holy cow, my plumber bill doubled. Well, of course it did because they have to run all of this, but now you don't have an HVAC bill. That may be $15,000 to $25,000 less on the build.
Okay, but now you need an ERV that needs ductwork? For an average ERV system, so both the ERV itself and the ducts, you pay $2,000 US. So an average of $10,000 for an HVAC system minus the $2,000 for the ERV. That's still $8,000 in savings. Now regarding operating expenses, an average ERV uses about 40 watts of electricity per hour. At the national average of 19 cents per kilowatt hour, that's about $67 per year. In comparison, the average homeowner will spend about $1,000 per year on heating and cooling. Finally, many modern ERVs come with smart functions like speed selection, CO2 concentration, monitoring, free cooling function, filter alarm, negative oxygen ion function, fan boost, optional humidity, wireless pairing function, multiple linkage, and Wi-Fi functions. I'm not quite sure if you need all of that, but I'd appreciate a notification when I need to change my filter. If I don't put it in my calendar, I would definitely forget about that. In conclusion, ERVs are extremely useful in homes that don't use HVAC systems for heating and cooling. Thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it. Thank you, Sergio and Bill, for being my Patreon members. Last week, I published my mental health breakdown last year. Quite a few people reached out, trusting me with their own challenges. And I was wondering if I can create value through transparency in the field. Since I'm not making a ton of money currently that can go into clean tech activities to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, I think the best I can do right now is filling the channel. And I think the value, and you comment and correct me if I'm wrong, I'm trying to provide value through clean tech edutainment, meaning that it's entertaining plus educating at the same time. And if you've been around for a little bit, you've noticed my passion for heat pumps in particular. I don't want to kind of blow up the mental health thing. I just want transparency with you and anyone who knows me. Anyway. We're getting a little bit off track. So be well, take care of your loved ones, and see you next time.